feature in the best new interviews and more from your favorite classic soul, R&B, jazz, and blues bands and performers. Classic Artist Today is proud to present Sitting In with the Cool Cat with Lisa Davis.
Welcome to this episode of Sitting In with the Cool Cat. I'm your hostess with the mostest, Lisa Davis, and happy to have you along. And of course, you know I am always happy to give you new songs from classic soul, R&B, blues, and smooth jazz bands and performers. In this episode, a stellar interview with the one and only Paul Taylor and the one and only Ray White. We've also got some tunes from Paul Taylor and some very cool showcase tracks to spin your way. I ask you to sit back as we get ready to get set, get ready, and get cool right here on Cool Cat as we give it to Ray White, as he's got a great interview right now with Paul Taylor right here on Sitting In with the Cool Cat.
I'm with the Cool Cat.
All right. Paul Taylor here with the Cool Cat. How's
That's
it going?
Right. Oh, it's wonderful, wonderful. Thank you for having me once again.
Absolutely. You're certainly a fan favorite on our show, and always love hooking up with you when you're here in town.
Thank you so much. Yeah, glad to be back in Hampton, Virginia for Jazz Legacy once again.
Yeah, Jazz Legacy is such a great time here. And, you got a new album out, And Now This. And I understand the title of songs, and I always wonder, especially on instrumentals, how these musicians pick titles of these songs. But I understand there's a little story behind that on this album.
There is a little bit of a story. So the title track, I had another title intended for the record, and almost not quite the 11th hour, but then, you know, I got this idea. Like, I was in a store shopping, and so in one of the stores in a mall, and so one of a clothing line, they'll have, like, you know, different clothing lines. Like, over here might have Yves Saint Laurent, but over here has something else, you know, whatever. Yeah. So anyway, in the store, it had this one line of clothing. It was called And Now This.
Huh.
And so it just struck me, like, and now it just, like, kind of, not really irreverent, but just kind of cool, and like not just like a noun thing or whatever. Mm-hmm. So, and like my title was going to be as something different, one of the other songs.
Yeah.
So I thought, you know what, I like this. It just rung with me.
Mm-hmm.
So I named that one the title track, and ran with that. And it's kind of just coming out of the COVID and out of the pandemic thing, and like this year's a new, like, we made the record during the pandemic, pretty much,
right?
And we never got in the same room together. We did it all remotely from our houses and exchanging files. Mm. And so here's the latest Paul Taylor, And Now This. Here it is.
Yeah,
that's basically the story.
Now, recording it that way, you certainly don't have the vibe and with the other musicians when you do that. What are other difficulties when you record both at separate locations?
Getting, like, having your own, like, my own little workstation all together to make the right, to get my sound just right and all the levels just right.
Mm-hmm.
And the tone and the so when it transfers to my producer, it's in the right way that he can receive it into his system.
Mm-hmm.
That can be like a little bit of a, you know, a little obstacle.
Yeah.
But we got, so it took, you know, it didn't take that long, but we did run into that at first from my end.
Okay.
Getting everything right and like the bit rate and all that, sample rates and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then, but then once we figured all that, then, like, you know, just like the way to record it and everything like that. So that really jumps out at me at first. But in the other ways, you know, is this good to, like, just bounce something off? Like, we're right here, like, bouncing things off of each other right now.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I'm like, there, you just, like, we just learned to do it, like, by just, you kind of just shoot it back and forth, and then, like, hey, just email or text, whatever, and then we just got used to doing that. But I think the your main answer to your question was the first one, like, just, yeah, getting, like, all my my technical stuff going from my end.
Yeah, yeah.
Get right in sync with his.
Now, do you talk to each other throughout that process, like, hey, if you could play this part just a little bit like this, or make this a little bit funkier or whatever?
Absolutely. So we had, like, some Zoom sessions as well. So we were, like, right there, like, real time I was recording it. And then, like, he really couldn't hear the music part, but he could hear. Well, I think we made it so we didn't quite get all that to that part, but we just, like, he was right there listening to me, like, and he would make suggestions and all that. And,
uh-huh,
and just like him being right there.
Yeah.
So So the next time we do it, if there's a new some kind of protocol they have out now that we can like be like in the same, almost like the same room, but we're but a far apart. Yeah. Hear everything that's going on.
Yeah, technology, it's amazing.
Yes, isn't it? Absolutely.
Well, Dino Esposito certainly has done a lot of work with you in the past. Tell me a little bit about him and how you hooked up with him and what exactly he means to you and to the sound you produce.
Well, you know, he's the greatest guy, one of my best friends. And we met back, I was maybe a year or two out of college, and he was still in college. And I was just gigging in Las Vegas, and a common friend introduced us. And then we kind of just hit it off right then and just kind of kept it going over the years. And then not too long afterwards, I knew he was doing music. Mm-hmm. And he had a four track and stuff, like, let's write some songs. And I could hear he had a really cool, his version of how he hears stuff. And I really resounded with me. So let's work on some music. And so we just wrote a lot of different songs and four tracks and whatever. Yeah. And then he was working on his stuff as well. So he became really big. He made it to the pop charts, had a top five pop single, like in the late 80s. Uh-huh. So he got his record deal on the pop side. Uh-huh. And so, you know, we were all in touch through there, and he had me in his band, and we opened for New Kids on the Block. We had national tours, bus tours, and everything. And so he's just the greatest guy and nicest guy. And I think deep down, he wants to be a producer. So that was like his way of getting to the producing, being an artist first. And then right. He got into the producing. Now, I'm sure if his career kind of lasted like three albums, and then the music kind of, you know, music changes, yeah. Especially in the pop. Like
yeah,
in jazz,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
We have like a more, it's more steady, it's more a linear thing. And on the other, more other formats, it's like up and down. You never know what can happen. So thankfully, you know, I've been around like how long I've been out. But his went very amplitude. And, he's just the greatest guy. And like, you know, he just knows all the tricks, all the tools of the trade. He's a great producer. And we just vibe really well, just like us talking right now. And we just get it done and just vibe it. We have a commonality of our musical likes and kind of like different kind of stuff that we like that we do.
Yeah.
And there's no superlatives, none of superlatives for him, really, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, again, on your new album, Straight to the Point is a tune we like a lot.
Yes, indeed. That was they released another song in the R&B for just a second, and then, you know, it made some traction. Mm-hmm. That was called Ride It, which is a cover song and kind of like a more club kind of song. Mm-hmm. More club kind of song.
And that was the only song with vocals?
Yes, that's the only song with vocals. That's a cover song, and uh-huh. It featured Jamie Jones from mm-hmm. All for One. Mm-hmm. And so, but then, so for Smooth Jazz, the first single was, like you said, Straight to the Point. Mm-hmm. And you know what? Not too long, it went straight to the top. So, yeah, really grateful. That was a great feeling, that knowing that, you know, There's a lot of music out there right now. A lot of people are jumping in the bandwagon. So, you know, you've got to come. You know, I wanted really, you know, it's been like about four years since Countdown. Mm-hmm. So I really want to make, you know, really want to make, put a strong project. Not that the other ones aren't strong, but
yeah.
I really want to make a really strong project and make it right down the middle, man, like a home run. Right, he hit a fairway drive right down the middle.
Yeah, yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
So we want to really just really hone it in and like really just really get solid in all mm-hmm. in all parts and so in all cylinders. So Straight to the Point was one of the songs, and I didn't pick the single, but one of the people that plug our music to the stations,
yeah.
They picked the single, so they did pick a really good song.
Yeah, yeah, and I really like Friday at 5 too.
That's
great,
a new single. Thank
oh,
you so much.
Wow.
That is a new single, and I think it's like it's top 10 now. It's number 9 as of Wednesday.
Yeah, yeah.
So, hopefully we'll get two number one singles on this record.
Yeah, yeah. Now you're on Peak Records now, right?
Yes, Peak Records and also BFD, which is Bob Frank Distribution.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Yes.
And have you done other projects on Peak?
Oh, yeah, almost all, like almost all the records are with Peak.
Okay. I mean,
which is my manager's label.
Oh, okay.
And Russ Freeman.
Yes, oh, indeed. Yeah, yeah, that's right. Yes. Russ has been involved with that from the get-go, hadn't he?
Absolutely, yes, indeed.
Yeah, yeah, Russ is a super guy. We've had him on our show several times. Have you ever had a chance to record anything with Russ?
You know, it's been a while since I did my Rippington stint, but, You never count it out. We'll see. We'll, yeah. You know, it's been a while.
Yeah. Well, great. Well, golf is something you enjoy in your free time. And when I check out your Facebook page, you're usually on a link somewhere. Just wanted to ask you, when you follow golf, especially from a professional standpoint, there's this kind of change going on with this LIV new circuit. Have you heard about that?
You're well informed. You know what? Exactly. I've been seeing about it too. And it's something with Saudi, like in Saudi Arabia, they have their own tournament. But like, they're paying those guys, they're paying like the big guy, the big hitters like Dustin Johnson and a few others like really big money to go over there and do it. And so, hey, if they're paying, you know, it's not all about money, but still.
Yeah.
So it's kind of controversial because like the PGA is like the, but you know what? It should be like, I don't think it should be monopoly. They should have a monopoly and everything, but they want to do it over there and they're getting a lot of, taking a lot of hits from doing that. But then on the other hand, Saudi Arabia has a couple things that, like on human rights, they have some human rights issues going on that are not cool.
Yeah.
So that comes to bear too. So wherever you want to draw the line on that.
Yeah.
I just check it out. Well, I just want to play golf and just be decent at golf, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know, you practice a little bit more. Maybe there'll be an opener on the PGA now that a lot of them are going over.
Oh, yeah. Hey, you know what? Yeah, we'll see, you know.
Yeah.
I'm just like a duffer, man.
Yeah, you and Gerald Albright, I can see you guys up there.
That'd be nice. You know, like one of my, you know, who knows what will happen, but have like a, you know, smooth jazz, like a little tourney, and just all of us at play, you know, have something that's organized and just get out there and play and, you know, have fun, have make a concert with like a annual thing with it.
Yeah.
Like we would play and then have a little golf tourney.
Yeah.
That'd be kind of cool.
It would be. Well, Paul Taylor, I always enjoy when you're in town. We have such a good time and always enjoy your shows. And thank you once again for spending a few minutes with us.
Honored to do it, Ray. Once again, you're a good guy. You're a cool cat.
All right. Thanks so much.
You got it.
Hi, this is Jonathan Butler.
Hi, everybody. This is John Oates of Hall & Oates.
Hi, this is Dave Koz with more Cool Cat.
Thanks again going out to Ray White, and thanks again to Paul Taylor. And speaking of Paul Taylor, his latest number one song from his recent studio album that dropped last year entitled And Now This, here is Paul Taylor, Friday at 5 on Settin' In with the Cool Cat.
Hi, this is Paul Taylor. Stay in the groove with more Cool Cat.
My name is Lisa Davis. I'm your hostess with the mostest, and always so happy to give you such great tunes in each and every episode that we do here at Sitting In With The Cool Cat. That tune right there, a classic track from Paul Taylor from the album Undercover, dropped in 2000, if I'm not mistaken on that one. The tune I spun you there was Avenue. Now, if you like what you're hearing, you like this episode, you want to hear it, share it with your friends, you want to find out about the other 130-some episodes that we have, well, you can do it. All you need to do is go to our website. It's coolcat.com. Remember that there are three O's in cool.
Featuring the latest from a classic soul, R&B, blues, or jazz band or performer. Here is our showcase tune exclusively on Sitting In With The Cool Cat. Oh,
romantic night in? Well, that right there was something for you from Dave Koz, who happened to be, happens to be our showcase artist within this episode of Setting In With The Cool Cat. But Paul Taylor, during that awesome interview that he did with Ray White, he actually spoke about Dave Koz. So I thought, why not spend some Dave Koz? From that 2021 release, the song entitled Summertime in NYC, Dave Koz right here for you on Setting In With The Cool Cat.
You're in tune to the coolest music on the planet. Cool Cat, classic artist today.
It's Sitting In With The Cool Cat, and it's where old school, it's new school again. Giving you a double shot from some classic artists with new material that they've got out. That right there was the album Forecast, the title track from it, Forecast, from the artist Jazz Funk Soul. And they are all of that and then some. Giving you lots of cool music right there. Finishing up this double shot, Jazz Funk Soul, right here on Sitting In With The Cool Cat. My name is Lisa Davis. I appreciate you so much, and I appreciate you letting me do what I love to do. Give you great music, talk about great music, and give you some good times as well. Thanks again to Ray White. Thanks again to Paul Taylor. And if you want to find out about this episode, share it with your friends, or hear it again, just go to coolcat.com. That's COOOLCAT.com.